I'm Haleigh, I'm 6'7", and my husband Brian is 5'8". We moved to Tennessee this year and we're pregnant. We weren't supposed to be able to get pregnant, so this makes this pregnancy a little more delicate.
Seeing one thing here, it's a big issue.
It's my fault.
I'm Haleigh, I'm 6'7", and my husband Brian is 5'8". Brian and I have been married about a year and a half. We moved to Tennessee this year, and it's been really good. It's a slower pace of life, lower cost of living. We're in a much more stable spot this year than we were last year, and there was just a lot of doubt and a lot of stress.
You're going slow, come on.
One thing at a time.
Who does the laundry around here?
Me.
Are you kidding me?
Everyone did tell us that the first year of marriage would be the hardest, and everybody's right.
We moved to Tennessee this year. It was a really difficult decision to leave both of our families. My family definitely questioned our decisions as well.
Got some news and we wanted to share with you.
You guys know that Brian went to Tennessee a while back for a job interview and they officially offered us the job.
And how does that work into your plans?
We're working on that.
Haleigh has had a dream to play volleyball professionally for a very long time. And now that's just gone. And it's just, really? You know, I mean, just like that, it's vacated.
Brian wanted Tennessee to be a new start for us, and I think he was absolutely right. Tennessee's been awesome for our marriage and getting to spend so much time together, and we're pregnant.
This is baby Carvalho. I am 7.5 months pregnant.
We are beyond excited to have a baby. We didn't think we could actually conceive naturally, so...
We put
the ultrasound on and we see the little, you know, little baby's face and...
Somebody cries every time.
Oh, yeah. Big, big softy.
Hey, not too hot. It's going on the belly.
You're perfectly temperatured water.
Are you excited?
Kinda. What are we doing?
It's a belly cast. Keep the baby belly forever. Today we're gonna do a belly cast to encapsulate the
Wrong word.
Yep. Pregnancy brain. Encapture? No.
No. Commemorate
the swallowing of the beach ball that is my stomach. All right, you gotta feel how hard the stomach is before we start.
I think we'll have a pretty tall baby. Baby this week is supposed to weigh 2.5 pounds and it weighs 4 pounds, 11 ounces. So I'm going with over double what it's supposed to be.
That baby's in there.
I know it.
All right, baby, we're gonna make you a hat.
You know you're not supposed to make me laugh with my ab. I'm excited about my giant baby. Brian and I call this our miracle baby because we were told by 4 or 5 different doctors that we couldn't get pregnant. And I have over 70 cysts all over my reproductive organs. And then I have a misshapen uterus.
I look like I peed my pants.
Don't you pee your pants every time you sneeze?
Thinking I couldn't have kids was probably the hardest thing that I've ever dealt with. I wanted to be a mom since I was a little kid. Never occurred to me that that might not happen. And so when everything kind of went down with doctors, I think we'd been married like 6 months. And I really felt like I was letting Brian down because he wants kids. And so I told him, like, you don't have to stay, you know. Yeah, he called me an idiot. He was like, I'm not leaving you because you can't have kids. But it was a hard 6 months, 7 months. And then we got pregnant with our miracle baby without trying. So we're excited.
Are you like thinking about hanging it on the wall?
Hanging it in the room.
We thought to have for a little while.
It would be a really good like chip bowl. We wanted like a platter. And doing the belly cast reminded me of like grade school, making like a science project out of it. It really felt like a fourth grade science project.
I mean, making a baby is kind of like a science project.
Yeah, but that's more fun.
Okay, I was talking about the actual process of like the baby forming, not the like. The baby just kicked.
Went away.
It's not gonna let you feel it. It never lets you feel it. It takes after you, it's a jerk.
The kid does not like me.
You have a little footprint in there.
Hey, stop kicking. We're trying to do a belly cast out here.
I have been worried that this is maybe my only chance to have a baby. I'm really scared that something's gonna go wrong. There's just been like a lot more gravity on every decision that I make. We're trying to hope for the best and be prepared for the worst.
Ew.
There it is, like a horn of plenty.
All right, I gotta go wash this crap off.
Oh.
Good?
Yeah.
So?
I just want to see the baby.
So today we're going to the doctor and getting our ultrasound. We're excited about what we're gonna find out and what we're gonna see.
I mean, are you like worried at all?
I don't know. I mean, it's always like weird. Like you assume everything's fine when you're home and then you go to the doctor and it's like my list of questions that I always have. Yeah. It has been a pretty high risk pregnancy. It was really high risk the first trimester just because the viability of getting the baby to stick, for lack of a better term.
I know we've got past like 12 weeks and that was good for like miscarriage. And then, you know, after 20 weeks, like it's supposed to like kind of fall off.
Yeah, yeah. And then, I mean, I feel like the baby kicks every day and I guess we'll know today if there's anything more.
Haleigh?
Yeah, it's us.
Come on back.
Okay.
I'm good.
Uh-huh. How are you guys today?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Preparing for the worst and hoping for the best is probably a... not a life mantra, but one of those things.
I feel like it's kind of a parental mantra.
Yeah.
Hey, Dr. Brody.
How are you all?
Good, nice to see you again.
Good to see you.
How's everything going?
Good, good. Just getting more uncomfortable by the day.
That's gonna happen more and more as time goes on. All right, let's go ahead and let's take a look at the baby.
Okay.
Go ahead and lie back if you would, please.
All right.
You guys excited?
Yes, oh, yes, we've been waiting to see the baby.
And we're not going to find out what you're having, correct?
No, sir.
Well, you've got more self-control than I do. All right. So the baby's head down.
Okay.
Bigger than average. One thing I am seeing here is this is the placenta.
Okay.
Right there. As I follow the placenta down, it looks like it may be covering the cervix a little bit, called placenta previa. That has some potentially serious implications, especially when it comes to delivery. Placenta previa is when the placenta, the afterbirth, the part that feeds the baby while in utero, covers the cervix, the outlet of the uterus. So as the cervix starts to open and the baby comes through, it has to come through the placenta, which is where the baby's getting all the oxygen. So when that happens, it causes severe bleeding, can shut off the oxygen to the baby, and put mom and baby's life at risk. At the time of labor, it's a big issue. It can set up a situation where you or the baby could bleed to death.